The eye's gone completely dark. I can't reach anyone on the station.
Noelle, Starborn, came out of nowhere.
Vladimir, get out of there!
He already left, said he was going to the lodge. Sam, he's still breathing, but oh God, all that blood!
Hello, Constellation, are you there?
Who are you? What did you do to our friends?
They call me the Hunter. And now that I'm here, your part in glimpsing the Unity is over. I'm already on my way. Say goodbye to your friends. It won't be long.
Forget about us! That Starborn bastard is after the artifacts! You can't let him take them! Pack up the collection, move it somewhere they can't find it!
He is right. We leave the artifacts, the Starborn will have them.
What about everyone on the Eye? We can't leave them to die up there.
I have your back.
I don't know how long it's gonna take to pack up the artifacts. I'll get started. Hopefully this will only take a few minutes, if my hands can stop shaking!
Everyone, find somewhere to take cover!
Where? You really expect them to barge through the front door?
Just be ready, Walter.
Could you all keep it down? I'm trying to work here. Are you all right?
Hello! Again!
I don't know
what we got!
Ignore the noise. Focus. Focus. We better keep moving. I have all the artifacts. Everyone, follow me! There's an old escape tunnel to the Well District. Come on!
Thank you.
No, you can't. Think about your little girl, Sam. Hold on for her.
Dad! Dad, get up! Get up! Please? Go away! I told him you were coming. He just had to hold on a little longer. I hate you! Leave me alone!
Okay, I admit, my famous personality wasn't so much help with this one. I don't think I'm going anywhere for a bit. Give the meds some time to kick in. You go ahead.
Oh, thank heavens. You're all right. Bad habit. I'll be all right. Go and help the others.
You're alive. Krix's ghost can keep waiting. No tears for the old. Got the others to worry about.
Vladimir! Oh, thank goodness. Where's Sam?
We need to talk locks and bolts. Lodge and the Eye are not secure. Just means he's playing the waiting man's game. He'll be back once we've done all the work of collecting the other pieces.
The Hunter, He probably found us because we're somewhere obvious. High populated area, just like how the Starborn found you orbiting Neon the first time. But the fact that they're competing with us to find the artifacts means they can't get them without searching.
So we put the artifacts somewhere in the fringe. Or on something that can slip from their grasp if they do another strike from the curtain. Fine idea. Starborn show up, you can burn helium in one spin of the grav drive to anywhere.
Here, keep the artifacts safe. I guess we'll meet back at the lodge after.
Constellation has suffered losses before, although none quite so violently.
If I may, I know our encounter with the Hunter is the last thing anyone wants to talk about right now, but he said something that I can't get out of my mind. Unity. Do you remember that? because he was stopping us, implying that we were getting closer to it. The thing is, I've heard that word before. It's an important concept in Keeper Aquilus's speeches.
The priest? Is the Sanctum Universum going to bless our little crusade of discovery?
It can't be a coincidence. The Sanctum has always believed that answers are out there in the stars. Look, I know it's the longest of shots and the biggest leap of faith I could ever ask us all to take, but why not talk to him?
And it would seem there is nothing to lose in doing so.
Thank you. I know it's not much to go on, but something about this feels right. I'll meet you over there.
I have been curious. I know that your role in Constellation was thrust upon you in an unusual way. But that experience does not demand that you stay. You could have delivered the artifact and then left. Why do you stay? One that, hopefully, will soon be solved. My past is complicated. Anyone here will tell you I do not speak much of it. But my family always stressed the importance of having a purpose in life. You must have a reason for being. Fun is not a consideration. I am not saying I am incapable of it, it just should never be a priority over other things. When I first came to New Atlantis, I was shocked at how many people go about their business every day like drones. They do their jobs, eat their food, sleep in their beds, all seemingly without concern for anything around them. Complacent. Their experience is so different from much of the settled systems. They do not know how good they have it. You believe I am too quick to judge. Perhaps that is so. Purpose cuts through adversity. I know that all too well. And these people seem to have no idea. I have. There have been times where I wondered whether it was worth it. My family is unique. Within the settled systems. I grew up outside the bounds of the United Colonies, or the Free Star Collective. My parents, and their parents before them, did not believe anyone outside our family could be trusted or relied upon. You can imagine, I am sure, how existence without ties to others is challenging in space. It has certainly proven valuable. Saved me. A few times, without question. For now, though, it would seem you and I have found purpose in Constellation. I believe that is enough. I am pleased that we have common cause, and have enjoyed our time together. Thank you. I'm not sure when things will feel safer. Yes, of course. Honestly, I cannot answer that. So many years have been driven by survival in intense circumstances. Leisure time has been in short supply. And I suppose I have conditioned myself to not think about it much. I do enjoy combat training, though I suppose that is hardly the answer you are looking for. You have given me something to consider. Thank you for that. All right, then. The lodge feels... you will be lost without me.
Something or what?
Need something, Captain?
Seems more distant in the lodge. I guess that is to be expected.
I need you to know how much it means that you came for me. There is no way to properly thank you or to repay you for what you have done. I quite literally owe you my life. As grateful as I am, it is hard to feel that my life does not come at too great a cost. Cora is now without a father because Sam put himself in harm's way, as he always did. He deserved better. Thank you. I shall try to remember that. That may be, but you were the one to take action, so you deserve the praise. Losing Sam will be painful for us all, especially Cora. But it was an impossible choice to make, and it would have been so much worse had you not acted. I know you are grieving. We all are. But revenge should not be our primary motivation. Sam might well wish to be avenged, but he would not want us to risk all our lives for it. What he would want is for us to finish the mission. We will press on. We will continue our search, and we will learn what these Starborn are trying to keep from us. Now we truly know the stakes are too high to do anything else.
Sure, when things will feel... I have sharpened a blade for this very occasion. Just in case we need it.
Here, I have something for you.
Yes. Well, it seemed like a good idea. I saw it earlier and thought... Of course. I will keep an eye out in the future.
Yes, exactly. It's like...
When someone insults you, you want to just beat the shit out of them sometimes, but you don't.
Well, not quite what I was thinking, but that's actually a great example, Marcus. The man in the story was cruel. Do you know why he was cruel? You must feel what he feels, understand his pain, accept it, and deliver it not back upon him.
Empathy. You mean empathy? But you say it like it's easy. Like anyone can just love a terrible person who has been terrible to them.
Yeah, why even bother? I mean, isn't the cycle of humanity peace and war back and forth, like forever? Seems kind of pointless to try so hard for something that won't last. Nothing ever really changes.
Well, it's not easy, no, but necessary. Because you see,
Keeper Aquilus, can we have a moment?
Ah, Mateo. It's been too long. How are your parents? Your mother still struggling with that azalea garden?
No, she figured that out a while ago. Had to adjust the pH levels in the soil. But, Keeper, I didn't come to catch up.
Oh. Well, what's on both your minds? Oh. Yeah. How humanity comes together, how we are to love each other, even as our universe becomes even more complex.
That's not exactly what we mean. Keeper, when you talk about unity, well, does it mean anything else? Something secret?
Perhaps we should talk about this inside. Now that we have a little privacy, why don't you tell me exactly what it is that brought you two here?
We've lost people, Keeper.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. And these Starborn, I take it they're different from the people of the settled systems? There have always been mysteries that seem to defy our understanding of the universe, beyond rational thought. We enter life as an act of someone else's faith in us. There's no way of knowing who we will become, and yet the risk is made anyway. So you've pushed into the unknown, not knowing where it would take you. And it's brought you here. And I think I can help. If you're willing to find your way in the dark for a bit longer, I can give you a path to discovering its meaning. There's an old story. Far older than the Sanctum Universum, of someone who walked the settled systems and saw every corner of it. This pilgrim claimed he found the true meaning of unity. I always thought of it as just a parable for trying to bring humanity together, but maybe it's more. I understand you have doubts, but walk with me just a little bit further. In my story, the pilgrim met the founders of the House of Enlightenment and the enigmatic cult of the Varun. And he gave them each a part of the truth. Then he goes to his final resting place to live out the rest of his days in contemplation of infinitum addendum, his addition or contribution to the infinite. But what if the story isn't a metaphor, but a code, a way of finding the pilgrim again, or at least his grave? Yes, Something must be there. I just can't put my finger on it. Maybe the answer will become clear when we have more. The House of Enlightenment and Varun have versions of this story. The Enlightened work out of the well here in New Atlantis, helping the poorest citizens find a better life for themselves. Varun worshippers are more enigmatic, but there is a lone zealot that was captured recently for attacking UC ships. I visited her a couple of times. Hopefully, she'll be willing to talk to you as well.
I'll stay here with the Keeper. We need to catch up. And I wouldn't mind asking him a few more questions.
A visitor? I have all the company I need. The great serpent shall reveal himself and shroud the entire universe, leaving only the faithful. Why do you hide among the accursed? You are promised. May you live eternal at his side.
I had no idea. That is an extraordinary claim to make.
Now, Kindred, what is it you need from me? I require no company. He knows not the truth. He sends another to ask more incessant questions.
It is something, at least, that he has come to speak with you. I suspect few others would.
The Great Serpent waits in the shadows. He will entwine the universe, and all but the faithful will be made as dust. That is the truth. No more, no less.
If the Keeper has been to see you, perhaps he has mentioned it?
Yes, I have spoken to your Keeper about this. I will tell you what I told him, and then you will leave me. Jinan Varun meets the Unbeliever. He gives false prophecy to Jinan. But such is Jinan's conviction in the Great Serpent, he does not hesitate. He cuts the Unbeliever down. But the Unbeliever returns. Jinan realizes the Great Serpent is testing him, and he will not be found wanting. 4 times they fight. Over 120 rotations of the planet they are on. Remember these 4 battles, Jinan, the Unbeliever says. Remember these 120 rotations. But Jinan knows this is blasphemy and delivers the killing blow. That is all. Strength and conviction show your worthiness to the Great Serpent. The kill is not as important as showing there is no doubt. I grow tired of speaking. Leave me, and take this. It is of no more use to me, and it is better kept by a promise of the Great Serpent. If you are free soon, could we talk? Things I wish to discuss with you. All those credits, and you just handed them away. I have no love for the United Colonies government, but do you not think this is more than a bit extreme? So you have done this to make some kind of point? To whom? All you have truly done is embolden these pirates and put the lives of who knows how many others across the settled systems at risk. Clearly not. There are few easy choices in life, but I believe this was easier than most. At least you see it now. If only you had seen it sooner. I cannot tell you what to do, nor force you to do anything. Is something amiss?
Problem?
If it's about the financial or food assistance programs, we are backlogged. Don't worry, we're doing everything we can.
Oh,
you're not. Sorry. Can I help you?
We understand that you are busy, but this might be important. Anything you could tell us would be helpful.
Listen, I've talked about this with him a ton of times, and there's no record of a Unity Pilgrim, but since you both insist, our early records are mostly administrative. Humanitarian projects, group counseling notes, charity expenditures. But there is a series of exchanges the founding members recorded in a lot of detail. It's the closest thing I have to what Aquilus is describing. A man walks into the first house of enlightenment. The founding members just call him the Drifter. So they think he's a charity case at first, but no, the Drifter asks them a bunch of questions. If your philosophy is built on an individual's own morality, what about the second person? That second person might disagree. Isn't the problem of two what you're really looking for? And the founders respond, each individual must understand how the second person lifts them up. All of human effort is a story of cooperation pushing us forward. And it kind of goes on like that. He comes back every week for a year, same conversation every time. Second person this, the problem of two that. Honestly, I think the founding members made it all up. There was a little more hesitation being openly atheist in the early days. I think they were experimenting with writing their own scripture. Fortunately, that got abandoned pretty quick. After the records of the Drifter end, you never see anything like it again. Sorry, I couldn't be of more help, but that's about all I've got. Hope you find what you're looking for.
Well, you're back. What did you learn? Was there something hidden in their stories, like we thought? If there really is a location the Pilgrim wanted us to find, those do sound awfully like coordinates. What else did you learn? Planets are often named by number. That second might mean the second planet in the system. Was there anything else? Yes. What he added to infinity. Maybe that points to a name. If we're looking for his resting place, we'd need to know the name of the star system, wouldn't we? Let's see. We have something that could be coordinates. Something that could point to a planet in a system. But what's the name of the system? Infinitum Addendum. What if we break down the parts? No systems named finite or add. That just leaves in and dumb. Well, that's certainly how I feel. Yes, that's it. The second planet in Indum. At 4 and 120. That's where you'll find the Pilgrim's resting place. And from there, maybe you'll find the true meaning of unity. Before you go, you've now spoken to many different perspectives in our universe. In a way, you'll be carrying their philosophies with you on this journey. I know you're looking for a specific unity, but if you had to guess what it was, what interpretation would you give it? Conviction. Another word for strength. Can the truth not be revealed to the weak? Someone with doubts. Your only path is forward, then? Finding the meaning of unity is a totality that you cannot ever step away from?
A certain amount of confidence is necessary if you are ever to trust yourself and your actions.
Well, I won't keep you any longer. This has been fun, I have to admit. Go, find your truth.
Someone made a concerted effort to survive here. And yet it would seem it did not work out. Is unreasonably low here. We should not stay long.
Let us see what wonders of life this planet hosts. Some connection to the creatures in the area. What could it mean?
Once again, we are triumphant.
Emissary, perhaps, and their ship, the Helix. I believe they ambushed you above Neon and demanded that artifact you worked so hard to gain.
Thank you for the stellar introduction. Your success is unprecedented. Before you came, we were just discussing how continued use of force against you is unwise. We are not a monolithic people. The Starborn are individuals. Some are united in cause. Others are in it for themselves.
We are all in it for ourselves. Some of us are just more honest. The Emissary threatened your ship, demanded you hand over your artifact. How is that so different from what I did?
We needed to warn you off. Every encounter with one of our kind could spell disaster.
For whom, exactly? I say whoever can collect them should.
That might be more productive.
Yes. Let's talk about what really matters.
The Unity. You are on the path to it. It is a place, a gateway. It is where we were reborn.
So, I gotta say, this part is more awkward than I thought. Hiding my face was way easier. I'm not who you think I am. This universe is only the first one you've been to. I've seen hundreds. Where I came from, I was the one who stayed at the launch to protect the artifacts. You died on board the Eye while we held off the Hunter.
One of me, at least.
I collected the remaining artifacts, and they opened the way to the center of my universe, and the doorway to an infinite number of others. That is the Unity. When I stepped into it, I became a Starborn. It's how I've entered other worlds, including yours. I have to. This is bigger than all of us. All the artifacts are needed to complete the armillary and open the way to the Unity. In every universe, the Starborn fight over them. Innocent people die. You've witnessed the power granted by the temples, the anarchy that can be unleashed. Someone has to decide who should get them.
Here it comes. The emissary tells you only the worthy should enter heaven.
You're twisting what I mean.
They're hypocrites. They use the chaos caused by the hunt for the artifacts to establish an order where they decide who's worthy. I attacked your launch because I wanted the artifacts, and you held me off. You got away. That wasn't some morality play. You didn't survive because of righteousness. You won because of persistence, luck, and skill. As I have done. Countless times.
I was also human once. But what does it matter who or what I was when eternity is within your grasp? You're learning. My other self wants you to walk the path he walks, to give up, to appreciate the universe you have. Easy for a person who's seen everything, done everything. I think you should see it for yourself.
You've never come this far. Not in all the universes I've seen. The path to the Unity is opening to you.
You're going to tip the scales one way or another. Better your hand be on one of our sides. Bingo.
How can you believe you can trust him?
I want a truce. Between all three of us. I will give you some time to think over which approach to the Unity is the one you want. Mine. Or the Hunter's.
Yes. Let's see how willing you are to live under someone else's rules. Just remember, one of us isn't trying to judge you.
I know we're not the same people we met in our... I'm sure you have more questions. Ask different. I never know who you are when I meet a new version. But so much of you stays the same. It's hard, but each universe is precious in its own way. Mine will never have its original you in it again. As yours won't have its real me. You've seen the terror the Hunter causes. Every time a Starborn goes through the Unity, They get more artifacts, find more temples, gain more power. We can't let more like him abuse these gifts to destroy whatever's in their way. It is not an easy experience to describe. But the Unity will speak to you. Offer you the chance to become Starborn. You will be leaving this universe behind to be reborn. Everything you were before will be gone. Maybe that's why it offers the choice. Compassion? Or is it testing us? When all the artifacts are assembled, the device they create is called the Armillary. In many ways, it's a model of the multiverse itself. Through it, you can reach the Unity. And from there, you can become Starborn.
The Emissary and their kind only want to control you. Whoever created the artifacts and built those temples is playing a game with us. One whose prize is access to the center of all creation. There are no rules. Whoever gets all the pieces wins. And I've won. Over and over. I don't kill for the Unity. I find the easiest pathway to it. I've simply found that it's the quickest way. Talking, forming alliances, waiting for the right moment to commit theft. It's all so tiresome. I'll admit, you getting away has been the most interesting thing to happen in quite some time. As soon as I realized what had happened, I knew I needed to wait until this meeting with the Emissary to decide what to do about you. No, we always end up having this meeting at this time. But it's the usual affair. Can we make peace? No. Oh, how tragic. Honestly, I was beginning to wonder why I kept tending. And it's a bad habit I started a long time ago. Perhaps I just like meeting the Emissary to gloat. But you have provided something quite new to talk about. Maybe you're a random die roll. Or maybe the Unity is finally responding to all my hard work. To see what would happen, of course. You might not understand just how many times I've done this. Usually, you're the one who ends up dead, and whoever cries over your body goes on to become the Emissary. Sometimes I manage to get you all bunched up and take care of the problem in one go. Sometimes the Emissary has gotten to me first, and I never arrive. Hundreds and hundreds of variations of me, packing through Constellation. And it's almost never you. You making it to your ship on your own. That's new. I took it as a sign. I don't get many of those anymore. They enter the Unity, take artifacts from others, employ force. All the things I do. I am many things, but I would never tell anyone what to do with their gifts. That is your decision, not someone else's. The Emissary wants to become the judge of who gets to enter, but the Unity itself doesn't judge.
Before you leave, I want to give you something. A way to another artifact, but also a lesson in how dangerous they can be. Seek the moon of old Earth. There are secrets there you must discover for yourself. Here, to open the way. do not always know if you are a person I should be helping. Forgive me. I have also found that advice is a poor substitute for experience. I ask you again. Go to Earth's moon. You should also talk to your colleagues in Constellation. I am sure they have gathered more information on the remaining artifacts in the fringes of space. Part of me wonders what they will all say about what you have learned. But I will leave that to you.
What is it? I will watch your back. I did not spend as much time here as some of the others, but I appreciate that I was still given my own room.
Hey, I've been talking with the others, and I'd like to get everyone together to say goodbye. You know, to Sam. Thank you. It wouldn't be the same without you there. I'll have everything set up in a few days.
Mateo told us about your pilgrim's voyage.
You found it, didn't you? The meaning of unity. I don't think I understand.
Saying we're living on the parallel. You for every universe?
Let's take a step back. This is everything we've been building towards, and the implications are a lot to take in. Could you explain the part about multiple universes one more time for everyone?
Yes, I wouldn't mind a little more detail.
And that's why the Starborn want the artifact so desperately. They're the keys to unlocking the infinite.
I don't even want to think about the physiological changes you'd need to travel between universes.
Plus what it would do to the mind? Enlightenment? Or oblivion? Like the Hunter.
You have the opportunity to reach the closest thing to your god that might exist. And you're second-guessing it?
One doesn't approach the afterlife without some trepidation. I suppose it's better that we do it than allow the Starborn to continue this game of theirs unchallenged.
Everyone stay focused. We're still in this to discover the unknown, even if that unknown has just gotten infinitely larger.
Not to make a sharp turn in a grand tale, but I got the eye fixed up. Bruised, but still blinking. Let me know when you're ready to follow up on what it's seen.
You forget.
These last glimpses from the eye are from the farthest fringes of known space. Could be the only remaining pieces. Catch a smile out there.
All right. Give me a moment. I don't know where to start. I need you to tell me what on earth possessed you to side with the Crimson Fleet and betray UC Sisteth. Have you completely lost your mind? It's almost as though I don't know you anymore. No, I'm not going to calm down. Don't you realize that by strengthening the Crimson Fleet, you've done irreparable damage to the United Colonies? Not to mention the fact that you've exposed the rest of the settled systems to one of its most dangerous enemies. Don't be ridiculous. Of course I still care. Though I ended my service with the United Colonies years ago, I continue to remain vigilant as to what's going on within its borders. Anything that has a negative effect on the UC can also trigger a negative effect on Constellation. Exaggerating. If anything, I'm understating the gravity of the situation. I demand to know why you've done this. Oh, I see. Finding our work terribly boring, are we?
I thought perhaps you'd enjoy the challenge of unlocking the mysteries of the entire universe. My mistake. Yes, you have. It's far too late to undo what's already been done. But it's comforting to know that you realize what you've done is wrong. I suppose that's a step in the right direction. We'll just have to wait and see if you're truly repentant for what you've done.
There's that empty feeling again. Whenever someone's gone, there's like a hole in the lodge where they used to be. Crimson Fleet ought to be pretty happy right about now. Must have been hard to decide what to do with all those credits. Are you satisfied with how it all turned out? Well, you certainly did that. The fleet now has the funding to do the harm they've always wanted. Everything is going to be more dangerous out there for everybody, including us. We need murderers and thieves as allies? What are you planning to do next? If that's the road you're taking us down, I'm not sure I can stomach it. I'm just thinking about all the people that this is going to impact out there. Regular, normal folk who just want to have a safe life. Space is already so unforgiving, so hostile to life. Humans are still so delicate out here. And now it's just that much harder for no good reason.
If you need time away from here, I'll understand.